Assalamu alaikum class. Today we are going to study about type 1 error and type 2 error in research. Basically, the point is that we never get to work on our target population. Our research questions are always about the target populations, but we end up having to work on samples. And there can be some restrictions as far as methodology is concerned, as far as matching is concerned. We are sometimes unable to remove all biases despite our efforts. So in the end, we can have errors, meaning the results we get, we say are likely to be true, but there is a chance that they are not true. And we describe this error in two ways. There is a type 1 error, which is also called the alpha error, which is the p-value. The p-value we are often referring to whenever we are discussing our results, that is the p-value, it is called type 1 error or alpha error or alpha value. Now, the other kind of error is beta error. Beta error, we might not have come across, but when we talk of a power of a test, especially when you're calculating sample size, you must have noticed that we enter a power of a test either 80% or 90%, right? That power is 1 minus beta. So it is relevant from that point of view. Let me start with alpha. First, I'll give you the practical definitions and then I'll tell you a story how you can remember it. Alpha error. Alpha error or type 1 error means to say that there is a difference, that there is an effect, when in reality there isn't. So it's a false positive, meaning you have case and control, suppose, and you detect a difference in frequency of a certain genotype, but it was not there in reality. If somebody had managed to test the entire population of the world with that particular disease, with that particular criteria, this would not have been there. But your sample size was such that you got the result. So there was a type 1 error. Effect, you detecting an effect when there was no effect, or you detecting a difference when there was no difference, and therefore you rejected the null hypothesis but erroneously. So type 1 error means erroneously, falsely rejecting the null hypothesis or falsely accepting the alternate hypothesis. Now, so why do we use this p-value? We use this p-value and we set it at a certain level because we know that because we are working on samples, there will always be a chance of, and because we are often using instruments which are measuring some variable indirectly and not directly, there is a chance of error. So what is our acceptable probability, which we'll say, okay, there is a probability I'm wrong, but it's a very small probability, so we'll accept our results. That is why we set the p-value. So 0.05, if you convert it into fraction, is 1 over 20, right? So when we say probability is set at 0.05, we are actually saying there is a difference in my group 1 and group 2, in disease and non-disease group in my samples. And there is 1 in 20 chance that I might be wrong, but this chance will be acceptable for me. If there was a 1 in 10 chance, which is a bigger chance, then I will not accept my results, but I will accept my results if the probability is 1 in 20 that my results are wrong. This is a decision we take because there will always be an error. Nothing will be 100%. So sometimes when you want extremely sensitive results, especially when we have these grant, big organizations giving grants, they demand that you set your p-value at 1 in p-value, let's say 0.001. So they want you to have your results at p less than 0.001. And that is a condition where you say that I'll accept my results if the chance of my error is 1 in 100. Obviously, that's a very small error. That is the meaning of p-value and the definition. Second is beta. And beta, I said, we come across it mostly with reference to power because 1 minus beta is power. Beta is when you do a result for example, to convert, detect antioxidant level or oxidative stress marker levels between COPD and non-COPD, and you don't find a result. But there was actually a result. Maybe your sample size was not enough, or maybe the kind of patients you took, they gave this result. But in actually, there is a result when you consider COPD patients. Your sample, your experiment, your study did not give the result. So it's a false negative. This is beta error or point or type 2 error. So you rejected, you accepted the null hypothesis. Null hypothesis said that there is no difference. You accepted the null hypothesis when in fact the null hypothesis was wrong and the difference did exist. You said there was no difference when in fact a difference did exist. So you accepted the null hypothesis, whereas the alternate hypothesis was true. So one minus false negative is true positive, and that is power. Power of a test, when we have to calculate, we say one minus beta error. So when we add in our sample size formula that power, we will require a power of 80%, we are saying that we will accept a beta error of 20%. That the possibility that our negative results might be actually not negative, there will also be that error will exist, some probability will be there, we will accept a minimum probability. So when we say that we will put the power of our, when we do sample size calculation, the power of the test will be put at 90%, we are saying that we are going to accept a beta value of 10%. Now, how to remember it? So remember there was a story we used to study, Peter, it was the boy who cried wolf. In Urdu, it's Sher Aaya, and in English, it's boy who cried wolf. So there was a shepherd who used to take his flock of sheep to a nice mountainside. And one day he just decided to be mischievous, and he just started shouting from the hilltop down where his village was, "A wolf has come, a wolf has come, and he's after my sheep." And the villagers just came. Now, over here, the null hypothesis is that there is no wolf, and the alternate hypothesis that there is a wolf. What is the reality? Reality is that there is no wolf. Let's get this straight. In this particular situation, the reality is there is no wolf. Null hypothesis would be there is no wolf, and alternate hypothesis will be that there is a wolf. Shepherd is shouting, there is a wolf, come on, come for help. Villagers believe the shepherd, and so they reject the null hypothesis, but they are wrong. So when they come, there is no wolf. They committed a type 1 error. They accepted a false positive. They erroneously rejected the null hypothesis. This is alpha error, the first time which was committed. And one comes first, so in the first part of the story, type 1 error is committed. So the next day, what the wolf actually comes. And now when the shepherd is screaming at the top of his voice and calling the villagers think he's kidding again. Now in this on the second day, what is the reality? Reality is that there is a wolf. Null hypothesis remains the same, because null hypothesis always takes the position of a conservative position, a position of null, that there is no wolf, null hypothesis, there is a wolf, alternate hypothesis. On the second day, the reality is that there is a wolf. But when the boy cries wolf, the villagers, they do not believe him. So they think it's a negative, but they're wrong. It's a false negative. So they commit a type 2 error. They believe there is no effect, where in fact there was an effect. So this was type 2 error, and this little story will help us remember type 1 and type 2 errors.